live on the NASCAR Amino Network. It's the Bristol Motor Speedway Dirt Nationals here at the Bristol Motor Speedway, where 40 Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series drivers will take on the world's fastest half mile, but on its dirt surface. This broadcast is brought to you by the NASCAR Amino Target Modified Tour, by the Miller Lite NASCAR Cup Series, not your ordinary MISC League, and by the Amino Race of Champions, where the Amino's best prove their legacy. Here are commentators for tonight's race. I'm Justina Ricardo, and I'm joined by Connor Campos.
Hello, everyone. I'm glad to be here.
Before we begin, let's meet the drivers in tonight's field. First up, starting 40th on the grid, 10th in heat race number 4, it's the driver, the number 01, Coco Pebble, CBMI Ford, Nick Nelson. Next up, starting 29th on the grid, 8th in heat race number 1, it's the driver, the number 36, UPS Chevrolet for Tau Racing, Raven Dagan. Next up, starting 28th on the grid, 7th in heat race number 4, it's the driver, the number 70, Aaron's Ford for Allen Motors, Sydney Allen. Next up, starting 27th on the grid, 7th in heat race number 3, driver the number 51, Fire Emblem Chevrolet for Eric Jones Racing, General J. Next up, starting 20th on the grid, 5th in heat race number 4, driver the number 35, Deer Ridge Racing, Liberty Mutual, Toyota, Colin Dover. Next up, starting 17th on the grid, 5th in heat race number 1, driver the number 24, Red Bull Chevy for Pool Motorsports, Baron Pool. Do the rock away. Now lean back, lean back, lean back, lean back. Come on, I said my knees don't dance, we just pull up our pants and do the rock away. Now lean back, lean back, lean back. Next up, starting 16th on the grid, 4th in heat race number 4, driver the number 30, Grave Digger Toyota for Deer Ridge Racing, Quinn Yeager.
On the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found.
Next up, starting 15th on the grid, 4th in heat race number 3, the driver, the number 37, Eagle CBMI Ford, JDF and Bregler.
We're no strangers to love.
starting 14th on the grid. Fourth in heat race number 2, driver the number 69, Lionel Racing Chevy for Pool Motorsports, Tyler King.
Out in the country, past the city limit sign, where there's a honky-tonk near the county line. The joint starts jumping every night when the sun.
Next up, starting 13th on the grid, 4th in heat race number 1, driver the number 91, Deeridge Racing, Outback, Toyota Camry, Logan Speed.
I think it's very vital to rock
around.
That's right,
on top.
It's tricky, it's so tight, here we go. It's tricky to rock around, that's right, on time. It's tricky, it's tricky,
tricky.
Next up, starting 12th on the grid, 3rd in heat race number 4, driver the number 1, FedEx CBMI Ford Fusion, Caden Bishop.
Do your worst. I've come to the conclusion you can kill me if I kill you first.
I told her run along and get away. I think I need to get away.
I need to call a timeout. I need to set another play.
I need an umbrella because every day feel like a rainy day.
I need something other than Xannies to take the pain away.
I run away to California. I'm trying to cut.
Next up, starting 11th on the grid, 3rd in heat race number 3, driver the number 25, Jason Elliott Racing, Napa Pontiac, Chris Black.
Oh, ah.
Next up, starting 10th on the grid, 3rd in heat race number 2, driver the number 20, Eric Jones Racing, Persona 5, Chevrolet, Dylan Jones. Next up, starting 8th on the grid, 2nd in heat race number 4, driver the number 48, Realtree Chevrolet for Pool Motorsports, Demo Goodnick.
Friday, quarter to 15, the week is through a sawback six-pack on my mind. Gas ball roundup, cramming into one truck, heading on out, we're gonna get a little rowdy.
Next up, starting 6th on the grid, 2nd at heat race number 2, driver the number 07, Aaron's Ford, 4, Hosemad Motorsports, Brandon Allen.
Baby, I can pay you 2 keys from a rose on the grave. Ooh, the more I get to you, the stranger it feels, yeah. Now that your rose is in bloom, a light hits the gloom on the grave.
And rolling off 5th on the grid, 2nd in heat race number 1, driver the number 15, Pepsi, Hosemad Motorsports, Ford, Caleb Marinelli. Next up, starting 4th on the grid on pole for heat race number 4, driver the number 00, Exalta, Ford Fusion for Hosemad Motorsports, Tanner now. Starting third, on pole for heat race number 3, driver the number 8, Axe Body Spray Chevy for Tau Racing, Zach Stern. And now, starting in the second position on pole for heat race number 2, driver number 62, Plato Chevrolet for Tau Racing, Carter Jones. I'm throwing caution. What's it gonna be? Tonight the winds of change are blowing wild and free. If I don't get out of this town, I just might be the one who finally burns it down. And finally, our overall pole sitter for this event, the driver number 75, Starbucks Chevy Monte Carlo for Tau Racing, Kylie Grider. It's the blade. And now that you've met the drivers for tonight's event, it's time we get going here at the Bristol Motor Speedway. We've got Kylie Grider still on pole, but she's elected the outside lane, a very interesting choice here, as the field gets ready to pull off.
Oh man, here they come onto the dirt for the first time.
So Connor, I'd like to hear your picks for this first heat race here.
This is a very, very interesting top four we have, but I feel like Seth Peters might actually come out and take this pole away from Kylie Grider and Caleb Marinelli.
I'm actually going to go with the 91 of Logan Speed there. He's actually in that points battle, even though it's fall a little bit. It'd be very beneficial for him to get those 5 bonus points to get his name heard again, as the pace car is going to make the hard left onto the pit lane. Caleb Marinelli and Kylie Grider take the green flag here in our first heat race.
Great start by that 15 car.
That outside line not working very well for Kylie as they're 3 wide behind them. Baron Poole makes 2 passes at once into the third position.
Oh man, he's on the charge at the moment. He's looking to go for that top spot. Right now he's in third, but Seth's now in trouble. He's got Jared Holmes behind him.
Yeah, Jared Holmes currently outside the transfer spot. Seth is the one that currently holds that spot. We'll see what happens as the race progresses. Now there's Logan Speed getting to the inside of Baron Poole.
He's trying to get a little aggressive right there. He's trying to get that third spot. He knows every point matters in this championship battle.
And now Kylie Grider thinking the same thing to the bottom of Caleb Marinelli. She takes the lead away here on lap 3.
Man, she fell back on that start, but now she has found her way back to the front. She might have some major speed under the hood of that 75 car.
It'll be very interesting to see what she can do. She was the pole sitter for this event. So she definitely has some speed under the hood, as now there's Logan Speed getting around Caleb Marinelli into the second position.
Oh, Logan Speed has some major speed under that Outback 91 car. He might get him right in the turns, possibly.
He's looking down to the inside. They'll be side by side off of turn 4. Logan Speed led that lap.
Oh man, that 91 car is looking to go at it. He might possibly try to get that pole position in this first heat.
As we look at Brian Leon, and right behind them is the battle for the transfer spot. Seth Peters currently holds the spot. Now it's Kylie going right back for the lead down the front straightaway and into turn number 1.
Oh, this is getting very tight between these two, and there's going to be a third person this far. Oh, no!
Seth Peters into the wall. Our ticker hasn't quite yet updated.
He kept it going, but how much damage is on that 78 car?
And now here comes Logan Speed back to the bottom.
Oh man, it's getting very tight between these three. Caleb Marinelli is going to try everything he can to get by these two. He's going to go for second now.
Contact was made between the 91 and 75. Come out of turn number 2. They almost got into that wall on the back straightaway, as you see Caleb Marinelli slotting into the second position.
this is a little breather for Logan at the moment, but Caleb Marinelli has some speed under that 15 car. He might try everything he can to get around that 91 car at any moment.
You see all that dirt on the top groove from Seth Peters' accident. That will be shown in a replay after this heat race concludes, but now it's Caleb to the bottom for the lead. Caleb Marinelli is going to slide up in front of the 91 of Logan Speed here down the back straightaway. As the top three continue to battle it out. Four laps to go. Now they're going to go, not quite, they almost went three wide for the lead there.
But now Marinelli has the lead, but this is about to be a wide situation.
There goes Kylie Greider right to the bottom of the racetrack, pulling a semi-slide job there, taking the lead away. And now Logan Speed also has the bottom, but there's a slow car in the way. That's Seth Peters.
It's, oh man, he might possibly block that high line and hold up Kylie possibly. Here comes Caleb on the bottom.
Caleb's going to force Kylie up into that high line right behind the lap car, and he and Logan are going to get by to be the leaders.
Oh man, that is a big bummer for Kylie. She's got to recover from that quickly, or she's gonna
One lap to go.
Start fifth or sixth in the state.
Lap to go. Oh, that was very close. Contact was made in turn one. Logan Speed couldn't get by Caleb Marinelli on the bottom, but through turns three and four, Caleb Marinelli, winner of her first heat race this evening.
Man, what a hard-fought victory for that 15 team in just heat one. This is very good for Caleb Marinelli, because that means he'll start on pole position for tonight's A-Main.
Yes, that pole position is very important, especially because Caleb interested to get into that championship battle, but not quite there yet. As the cars will pull into pit road, we'll get a replay of Seth Peters' accident here very shortly. Can't really tell justice from that corner, but it seems like he slipped up the racetrack and got into that wall. Could Jared have something to do with it?
I feel like Jared had to have something to do with it, because he was right behind him at that moment. I don't know if there was clear contact, because this camera angle didn't really tell the story that much.
Moving on board with Seth Peters, I think he may have gotten tapped or something by Jared.
Yeah, from the looks of it, I saw a little bump from behind or heard a little tap. Now we get it right here.
Oh, he dumped him. He just straight out dumped him.
Yeah. I was surprised by Jared Holmes. He's an aggressive driver. He doesn't care who's in his way. He'll pass anyone at any cost.
Caleb Marinelli, winner of the exciting first heat race tonight. We'll be right back after this brief commercial break. Dirt racing fans to the Bristol Motor Speedway for heat race number two of the Bristol Motor Speedway Dirt Late Model Nationals. Carter Jones, your pole sitter for this first heat race, as he'll lead the field off of pit road.
Oh man, round two. Let's hope we can see another good show after heat one.
So Connor, I'd like to hear your picks yet again for this heat race.
I feel like that 62 car is going to start first and win this heat. So I feel like the 62 Plato machine might win this heat.
It's a very good pick. I'm going to go with Dylan Jones, however. He's running the third spot. He's been a pretty underrated performer all season. I think he can get it done in this first stage. It's Carter Jones off turn number four. Green flag in our second heat race.
Carter with a great start right there.
Now Dylan Jones trying to peek to the bottom. He's cleared Brandon Allen already. Now he's looking to take the spot away from his cousin.
Oh man, it's getting a little tight. Top four right together. Here comes Tyler King for third, possibly.
Contact is made.
Oh, man.
Tyler King to the bottom. They're three wide in the back, too. Very close racing here. Now Tyler King to the bottom for second.
Oh, here comes Tyler. He's got some major momentum on his side. He might possibly try to make a run for this Heat 2 win.
Yep, as now he's going to go to the bottom of Carter Jones here for the heat race lead.
Oh, man. That 69 car is trying his damnedest to get by that Plato machine. Here comes the Lionel machine, possibly to the race lead.
And there he goes, Tyler King, new leader here at Bristol. Dylan Jones not far behind.
Man, now he's got to hold off the competition behind him, but Dylan Jones has some speed under that car. He possibly could make a run at Tyler King at any moment.
Well, we'll see here, but Tyler King seems to have gapped that 20 and the 62. The two Joneses off turn number four. 10 laps to go in this heat race here. Dylan Jones slowly but surely making up ground, but Carter's going to go to the bottom.
Oh, man, he's going to try to make that pass on the back straightaway heading into turn three. He might try to get him exiting turn four.
And he's cleared him.
Oh, he's got some momentum.
Now Carter's going to get to the bottom line. He's going to try to take back what he started with. Contact is made down the back straightaway. Off turn number four. They're right to each other's bumpers.
Oh, man.
Oh, they're making contact. They're sliding up the track.
Oh, man.
Oh, no. And they save it. But that's going to allow Dylan Jones to take the
lead. But how much damage was caused by that incident?
We shall see. Again, these dirt late models aren't really badly affected by aerodynamics, but you don't know if there's some suspension damage with that wheel-to-wheel contact. But doesn't seem to be affecting Carter. He's going to go back for the lead here.
Just a few seconds ago, he was in the wall. Now he's going back to the race lead.
Carter Jones back to the lead on his cousin Dylan Jones, and they almost make contact again.
A near slide job gone wrong, but a great save by the 62 machine.
Well, these drivers are racing super aggressively here in the second heat race. They're making contact all over the racetrack, and there it is again.
Oh, man, Tyler King, you don't want to do it again.
Now Tyler King back to the heat race lead here. Carter's going to tread again on the bottom.
Oh, my Lord, this is getting intense. I'm loving this heat race. I love these guys beating their doors and slamming each other for this stage win.
Yeah. These guys are not giving up. Tyler King and Carter Jones having pretty good battles so far. Three laps to go here. Tyler King is your leader.
Man, that was a close side-by-side battle at the start-finish line. I was hoping that was the final lap, but we got some more racing to go heading into the seats.
Carter back to the bottom. Only two laps to go here. He's going to try it again. They're going to shove each other on the track again.
Oh, man, he's going to attempt a slide job.
Not again. No. Carter to the wall. He didn't save it this time.
Oh, he's going to the wall again. And he's spinning.
Oh, Tyler Scott.
Oh, no.
Oh, big accident.
Oh, no.
He's going to get Tyler King.
That is a big blow for that 62 team.
That's going to put him in the B main towards the rear of the field if he does end up finishing this race. But that engine is toast.
Yeah, I don't know if he'll be able to make it to the last chance qualifier. But Tyler King wins this stage.
And it does seem like he's finished the race along with Kyler Scott. They limped their way to the start-finish line.
Yeah, but there's smoke coming out of that car. I don't know how bad it is. They got a lot of work to do during this break.
Well, luckily for them, per rules, they would be allowed to go to a backup car if they did bring one. But here's a quick replay off turn number two. They just make contact.
Yep, plain and simple. They were just racing very hard for this heat win, and it ended up taking out Carter in the process and collecting Kyler Scott, who had a potential chance to get into the A main, ends up being involved in this wreck.
Both of their engines go up in smoke here. We're going on board with Brandon Allen. Very close call.
Oh, man. What a lucky moment for that 07 endurance machine.
I'm going to go on board with Kyler Scott here.
Ah, nowhere to go, man. I feel sorry for that 17 team. Ended up possibly going from the A main to the B main in a matter of seconds.
Poor Kyler said bad luck all season. Got his run at Bridgehampton, but that's about it for him.
Yep. Now he's got to fight his way into the main event in the B main for the last year's qualifier. Oh man, this is going to be an interesting shot right here.
Tyler King and Carter Jones. Oh.
I don't understand why he's doing all that slide job and stuff. Carter's been doing that on Tyler all day long, and it ended up fighting him in the end.
Well, but anyway, Tyler King, winner of a chaotic and aggressive second heat race. We'll be right back after this brief commercial break. Dirt racing fans to the Bristol Motor Speedway for our third heat race. Zach Stern on pole, and it appears already Justin Newman with issues firing off his car.
What is going on? This is a stunning turn of events. The entire bottom lane's already on the track while half the other cars are on pit road, and Newman can't get going.
Now we started it up.
At the starting line.
Had a few technical difficulties there, but we're back. Yeah, they're gonna go green anyway here.
What is this stuff? This is confusing as hell, but anyway, Zach is gonna take the green under this unfortunate circumstances from Justin Newman.
Yeah, green flag into the air here. Zach Stern with the lead. Here is Justin Newman diving it down pit road.
Yeah, that might be a mechanical problem. He might end up retiring from this race and possibly the remainder of this race weekend.
We'll see here. Here's Zach Stern continuing to lead the way.
Got some smooth sailing at the moment, but maybe Chris Black can make a run at him, but he's right now too far back on him.
Taking a look at Justin Newman, who's still making his way off of the pit lane. There's JD Breglin making his first ever start.
And maybe he's going to try to race his way into the main event under these circumstances that gave him a big opportunity.
Right, as we come to the start of lap four here, Zach Stern with no competition, over a second lead on Chris Black behind him.
He's got to continue to race this race how he can to get this third starting spot, because you know if he thinks about slowing him down, the competition will quickly close on him and take that top spot away.
For now, it appears Justin Newman has been able to get back onto the racing surface, seeing all that smoke on the bottom lane. Zach Stern continuing to lead the way here, now with 10 laps to go.
It's just been smooth sailing for that A car. This might be an easy, easy heat that no driver has ever experienced in this series history.
Yep. Now we'll take a look at Roberto Crown. He's holding the transfer spot right now, but JD Bregler is charging hard right behind him.
JD has some speed under that Philadelphia Eagles machine. Maybe he could possibly get his way into the A main, replacing the injured Benjamin Maloney.
And we'll see here. He's gaining a lot of ground here already on Roberto Crown. He was stuck on that outside lane, so was kind of hurt by what happened to Justin Newman on pit road.
Yeah, it's definitely helped a lot to him running that bottom line. He could possibly get Roberto very soon. He just needs to run that bottom line as tight as he can.
He's taking a peek down low. He's not going to quite. Now he does, right to the bottom.
Oh man, up. Here comes JD on the bottom.
Side by side for the final transfer spot, JD makes it look easy.
Now he's got to hold off that Chips Ahoy machine of Roberto Crown Jr. But Roberto is not giving up that quickly. He's going to try to get under JD.
Yep. Roberto Crown already taking another peek down on the bottom with almost five laps to go here. Now he's down on the bottom.
Oh, man, this is very exciting. Even though the battle for the lead isn't that intense, but we got great battle for the transfer spot. Oh, contact again.
Contact made throughout these corners. Now Roberto Crown down on the bottom doesn't quite pull off the slide job.
Oh, JD with a little tap on the side of his car. He's very displeasured by that move that Roberto Crown Jr. just made on him.
And here's another small battle. Pedro Fluffington, Jacob Warrio. Pedro to the inside. Then we'll go check in on JD again.
But anyways, the battle's heating up between these two.
And what a pass by JD. Gave him some room and even gap Roberto Crown too.
What a great move by that 37 machine. He's possibly going to get into the A main very soon.
Zach was two laps to go here as he comes down the back straightaway. Seems to have put another lap on Justin Newman. Two laps to go as well here for JD Bregler and Roberto Crown, seeing he makes the B main.
Oh man, this is good. Will Roberto use the bumper possibly?
We shall see as Zach's turn on the final lap is going to take it through turns 3 and 4. He's going to cut Gavin Grant a little. No, he's not. But either way, he's going to win our third heat race here. And we'll wait here. Who's gonna get to the line first for the A main spot?
It's gonna be.
Oh, they were side by side. I think
oh
JD got him.
That was intense. JD Bregler possibly might have had that final transfer spot over Roberto Crown. I don't know about that.
That was by 400ths of a second JD beat him.
Wow, that is JD in his first ever Amsoil Dirt Late Mile race will race in the main event in the Philadelphia Eagles colors.
There he is pulling it down the pit lane. And we'll quickly get a helicopter shot of that finish. Here it is, the margin of victory.
Crazy how the high line was a pain to him on the start of this race, but yet in the end it helped him get into the main event.
Yep, very great finish here in this third heat racing event. As yet, Zach Stern wins our third heat race after an exciting finish for the final transfer spot. We'll be right back after this brief commercial break.
Boy, howdy.
How you doing, fam?
I'm here to show you why Chevy has the most dependable trucks out there.
Oh. Cool.
This sexy truck was made in the year 2000. Get this, the same year I was made. This truck also won the longest truck award, which I guess we're proud of. Chevy is also number one in reliability for the 920th year in a row.
Wow, that's freaking lit. Let me take a test drive.
No!
Welcome back, Dirt Racing fans, to the Bristol Motor Speedway for our fourth and final heat racing event of the evening here for the Bristol Motor Speedway Dirt Nationals with Tanner Campos on the pole as he's about to lead the field off.
Now this is a very, very important heat for everyone because there's five more tickets into the main event here at the Bristol Motor Speedway, and we still need to know who those final five people are.
Yeah, that, and you have to make sure you're not in the B main, because the B main could give you some very great anxiety trying to get those actual final five spots. But now, that'll be Tanner Campos leading the field through 3 and 4 off turn 4 as the pace car made the hard right on the left pit road. Green flag here for the fourth heat race.
Oh, Oh, dang, that double zero with a great start, but Kane Bishop's right behind him. Let's see what Demo Redneck can do on the high side.
Oh, they're already spinning in the back. Quinn Yeager around.
Oh, no, Quinn.
Quinn Yeager around. Three other cars involved. Elon Solberg, Chase George, Sydney Allen.
Oh, no. That is a huge blow for those guys who are trying to race their way in.
Big accident on lap one of this heat race. Caden Bishop gets away with the race lead. Now it's Demo Redneck. Colin Dover to the bottom.
My. Here comes Colin Dover on the bottom. Oh, contact.
More contact with Tanner Campos as well.
Oh, my goodness. These seats have been insane, but here comes another four-car battle.
Tanner Campos peeking down low again for the lead. I don't think he's going to have the speed off turn number two. Not quite.
Very intensely. Here comes Campos trying to get his top spot back.
And now Colin Dover is going to wash up a little bit towards the high line. That's going to let Tanner and Demo to the bottom, but Demo's going to go to the high side. Contact!
Oh man, they are really going at it for this final heat spot. Especially the top spot, that'll mean fourth place for the A main.
Now Tanner Campos to the lead, but Demo's looking back on the bottom. Caden Bishop has just about lost this group.
Demo on the bottom, he's gonna get it.
Demo to the lead here with now Colin Dover going to second.
That 35 car and 48 truly have something for that double zero at the moment as they're trying to duke it out for this race win, but they still gotta worry about that double zero behind them.
Again, Colin Dover and Tanner Campos are both top four in the points. Once we get later on in the season, those points could mean the championship. It's three wide for the lead.
Oh, what a gutsy move by that double zero!
Tanner Campos with an aggressive move on the bottom. It's going to pay off for him as he's going to take the lead off turn four.
I don't know if he can't hold off these guys behind him because they have some major speed under the hood of their race cars, and that double zero doesn't happen really much at the moment.
But there's
slap cars in front of them.
There are slow cars going to get in the way, the wrecked cars of Quinn Yeager and Elon Solberg. We'll see what happens when this group approaches those cars.
This might play a huge factor.
Now Colin at the bottom, Demo gets close to some contact, and now Colin Dover is going to take the lead. Three wide! Tanner stuck behind Elon Solberg!
Oh, it's going to affect Campos the most, but anyway, he's back up going. He's going to continue battling for this race lead.
Now he's going to go ahead and help Demo to the lead, with Colin Dover stuck on that high side, four laps to go.
Oh man, I feel like any one of these guys could possibly win this heat to get that most important fourth place, because it still means a lot to win this heat.
And now Tanner Campos is going back to the lead with three laps to go. Colin Dover on the bottom as well.
Oh man, he's got the control of this race, but I don't think he can hold them off for a little bit longer.
And now Colin's going to get to the bottom. He's going to take the lead easily off of turn number four with two laps to go.
Oh, man.
There's another slow car. There's Chase George, another slow car. They're going to come to the white flag here. Tanner's making contact. One more lap to go here.
Will he use the bumper?
There's Chase George. How will these guys get around him? Demo's going to take advantage. Demo's going to take advantage to the bottom. Demo Redneck wins heat race number four.
For second.
Caden to third.
Oh my lord.
They were three wide for second. Less than 200 separated fourth and second place. Appears that Connor Campos has been having some technical difficulties, but Demo Redneck, winner of this heat race. Here, we're going to take a look at the replay. Spun Quinn. They were three wide off of that corner. Quinn couldn't handle it and got hooked by Trevor Davidson.
Yeah, they were racing very aggressive on lap one. It truly shows how much this race means to them. And it ended up paying the price for all those guys in the back.
I don't know what ended up happening to Elon Solberg. He just drifted up the track right into Sydney Allen. I guess he may have had a knee-jerk reaction to spinning Quinn Yeager.
Can't sacrifice for everyone, Bond.
Yeah, we just got along one day with Ken Yeager. He was great in the car. Now we're getting on board with Elon Solberg here, so he's sitting right in front of him. He just went right up the track into Sydney.
Oh, bump. Right into the back of Sydney Allen. But Sydney managed to keep it going, but Elon did not.
Interesting here as it's Demo Redneck winning an exciting final heat race. We'll be right back after this brief commercial break. Welcome back, dirt racing fans, to the Bristol Motor Speedway for our B main event tonight. With five more spots to set in our main event, Jared Holmes starting on out front, leading the field off. Conroy, I want to hear your picks.
This is a very, very interesting heat race, but I feel like Jared Holmes needs to win this to keep his championship hopes alive.
But don't forget, Carter Jones, Kyler Scott, Seth Peters starting in the back. I think that Carter Jones can get it done.
That's very true. Tau Racing has been very dominant in these heat races. And a couple races ago, Kyler Greeter came from the back and won it. So anything could happen.
Green flag here for this B main event. Jared Holmes off to a great start. Roberto Crown about a slot in a second.
Great start by the 96.
Oh, there's contact right behind them.
Oh, near contact. Nothing serious at the moment. Well, we stay green at the moment.
Gavin,
but this is going to be very tight for Carter.
Kevin Grant almost went around right in front of Carter and Seth. That would have been bad for both of them. No, Nick and Noah Wentz will get loose.
Man, this traffic is going to be a real pain for Carter Jones and Kyler Scott. They have to slowly ease their way through the field as Kyler is making it easy and Carter is struggling.
And here they come. Oh, very close there with Justin Newman. They're four wide.
Oh, my Lord.
No one's going to give an edge here as Carter's threading the needle through all this lap traffic.
He's finally making his way through traffic, but he's got to make it easy at the moment. There's a spot in the main event. It's on the line.
Yes. As now Jared Holmes leads the way while all this battling continues. You got a 1 second lead over second place in the Allen, but Kyler Scott's made his way through the field. Oh,
man,
they're back into the back.
That 17 car is somewhere. Oh,
Quinn Yeager again. Elon Solberg, Marco Suarez. That's going to bring out our first caution of the night.
Well, the chaos has finally picked up, and it ended up collecting multiple cars in that incident.
Who's going to go slow down to a cautious pace here? Our top three: Jared Holmes, Kyler Scott, Sydney Allen. And here's the torn up race car of Elon Solberg.
He's had a rough night at Bristol. He's probably ready to move on because I don't feel like that car has any chance of making the main event at this point.
No siree. As he'll go get a replay, Colin Dover at it again. Not Colin Dover, Elon Solberg.
Man, what is Elon thinking tonight? He's been involved in multiple incidents on dumb decision making. That is very, very dumb on his part to do that.
Not a smart move at all. With that last contact with Marco Suarez there too, I guess Marco was frustrated with him.
Yeah, I don't think Marco. He should probably be the most enthusiastic. Ended up taking out four cars in the process.
That was an onboard there with Kim Yeager. Finally got onboard with Nick Nelson. He was right on the high line, minding his own business, and that happened.
Yeah, no.
There it is.
I don't know
what he was attempting. Was he trying to attempt a slot job? That just did not work at all. It ended up taking himself out in the process. Elon needs to really think about this race and learn his skills behind the wheel.
Yeah.
Well, he was sustained on the gas while others were on the brake, and he ended up taking out multiple people in the process, including Marcus Suarez slamming him into the atmosphere.
As now, we'll welcome you back to our live coverage. The lights have just gone out on our Dodge Challenger pace car.
And the intensity is about to pick up even more. Kyle Scott can breathe a little top five at the moment to get into the main event. So this could be a good chance for him to win this heat.
Yep. So now we're on our final lap here of caution. Pace car makes a hard left out of the pit lane. Green flag goes back in the air for Jared Holmes.
A slow start by that 96. Kyler Scott might try to get a run on him in the turns, and he's going to go for it.
Down to the bottom, side by side for the lead. Kyler Scott's going to take it away from Jared Holmes.
Man, that 17 car has something under the hood. And here comes Carter Jones, a guy you talked about earlier before the main start, and he's making his way to the front.
He has shoved Jared right up the racetrack, and here he comes to second.
Man, those two have been putting on a clinic, even though they got involved in that first incident. They are easily going to dominate this race moving forward, unless the competition behind has something for them.
And that's Seth Peters slotting into the third position right in front of Jared Holmes, who wrecked him in the first heat race.
Is Seth going to possibly think about revenge in this heat, or just try to race him as clean as possible?
Possibly, as we have a lead change out front, it's Carter Jones.
Man, that Plato machine has something under the hood. He possibly could make an easy way to cruise by this competition, unless Kyler Scott has something for him.
As we take a look as the field pushes turns number 1 and 2, Carter Jones putting a pretty big gap between himself and Kyler Scott with almost 10 to go here.
Oh, man. That 62 has some major speed, but Kyler is slowly fading away. He might have used up his stuff during his way to make his race speed, so he might be just settling down in second place.
Saw back there at the edge of our cameras, that was Seth Peters going for third on Jared Holmes, and Carter Jones just strengthened his lead by about 2/10.
No competition for the final transfer spot at the moment. It seems like Pedro's going to try to lead the way, but here comes Roberto. He might have something for fifth place.
Roberto Crown's actually looking for sixth on Pedro Fluffington. Sydney Allen holds that final transfer spot. There he is right there.
He's got a huge gap on him. Sydney has a huge gap on that group behind him, so he might be able to cruise at the moment, but Roberto honestly has the fastest car in that pack, and he could possibly make a run at Sydney if he can get clear.
This year is a similar sight for Seth Peters, not one that he really enjoys, but he's leading on Jared Holmes right now.
Seth is probably feeling very, very uncomfortable at the moment with Jared Holmes behind him, and Jared might honestly do it again, or he's going to find his way to third.
There he goes, pushing it up the track, Jared Holmes to third.
Oh, but these two are going at it. They are not letting each other go. Seth Peters was really frustrated at Jared Holmes for his incident in the first heat race, and he might try to get
back.
Oh,
and the caution has come back out. It's Marco Suarez.
Oh, dang. Marco Suarez's rough night continues.
That might do it for this B-Main.
That was insane.
Yes, sirree. Here's Carter Jones, your most likely B-Main winner. We'll have to see as the field. Alright, I have returned after some technical difficulties.
Just back in time, we're still looking at replays at Marco Suarez's incident that ended up caused by something that happened earlier in the race. I don't know what Quinny and Marco had done to cause this incident.
A very interesting incident here with Marco Suarez. As I think that might do it for the race. This is the white flag lap, and the pace car seems to still have its lights on.
What a hard-fought victory for that 62 machine. He might have something for that main event crew, because he has some fast speed under that 62 Play-Doh machine. He's going to get his ticket into the main event.
And there was the checkered flag right there. Carter Jones, the winner of the B-Main here at Bristol.
What a charge through the field, and he gets the job done in the pre-main event.
All right, our cars will bring it onto the pit lane here. Carter Jones is going to lead them on. Carter Jones wins a chaotic B-Main. We'll be right back for the main event. Welcome, dirt racing fans, to the main event here at the Bristol Motor Speedway for the Bristol Motor Speedway Dirt Nationals in the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series. Caleb Marinelli on pole for this main event as we'll get a track side for the command. As the cars roll off, let's take a look at our starting lineup for tonight's main. This time.
Oh man, this is going to be one hell of a show here at the Bristol Dirt Track. These guys are ready to go at it and sling some dirt into the crowd.
Here they come with the green flag here. Caleb Marinelli leads into it. Zach Stern right on his tail.
A great start by the 15 car. And here comes Zach Stern, possibly going to spoil the party and let Caleb lead this first lap.
And he's doing just that off turn number four. It's Zach Stern leading the first lap of this event.
Good move by Zach Stern. He's possibly going to get this. He's looking to get this W tonight. This race really means a lot to him because he's been heartbroken in multiple weeks.
And he's going to lead the second lap here as well with Logan Speed right behind him. Caleb Marinelli's dropped to third.
Oh, man. These two have been rivals all season long. They have been very close to that championship picture, and Logan is trying his best to get by that A car.
So I was going to take a peek to the inside. It didn't quite have the speed down the front straightaway. As close contact for third!
Oh my, that was very close. What a save by Dylan Jones and Kylie Greeter.
Very close indeed, but now it's Logan's speed to the lead of this event. With Zach Stern right behind him.
That 91 car has been, he has shown a lot of speed throughout this Bristol weekend, and he possibly could try to steal the victory away from Zach Stern if they can end up battling throughout the remainder of this race.
Now it's Caleb Marinelli who's caught back up into the third spot. Zach Stern making contact in turn one.
Oh, wow, that was tight. These is proven that this dirt track has been a real pain for these drivers.
You got to Caleb taking a peek down to the inside of Zach Stern.
Oh man, here comes the mozzarella man in that 15 Pepsi machine. He's going to try to get second from Zach Stern in a very tight battle for the race lead.
And there he goes. He takes that lead away. Not the lead, the second place spot with ease, but now he's hunting down the leader.
He's got some momentum under that hood of that 15 car. He could possibly, he's been running smoothly through these turns. He honestly has the best handling car at the moment.
And he's already taken a peek down low with Dylan Jones slotting into third, Zach Stern dropping back to fourth. And he's sliding up the racetrack.
Oh, a little door bang.
Into the wall, around he goes.
Oh no.
Back into the wall with Logan's speed.
And they're both in the wall again.
Demo makes some contact. Kyler Scott again.
Oh, not again. Oh, Seth Pierce was in it too, but Kyler Scott has had a rough night. And it looks like a day-ender for Caleb. And Kyler Scott has possibly damaged what is left of his race car.
That is a rough night here for Kyler Scott. Caleb Marinelli, after winning our first heat race, is going to end it early here. Only on lap 10 of the A-Main.
What a heartbreaker for that 15 team. They possibly could have won this race if this incident didn't happen.
Here's a replay here. Oh, some hard hits into the wall, both in turn 3 and on the back straightaway.
Yeah, they've been racing very aggressive exiting that turn. And side by side, it's truly not working there. More hits by Kyle Scott.
On board Caleb. He got hooked into the wall. I don't know if Logan came back up or he went down.
He probably thought, his father probably thought he was clear and told him to move up, and it ended up costing him in the process. And that one hit by Kyler Scott did it.
He's on board with Kyler Scott. You see them spinning up into the dirt in front of them. And they're always going to come into turn number 3 like a wrecking ball.
Had no time to react to Caleb Marinelli coming down the racetrack and ended up paying the price for him again.
Big hit here by Kyler Scott. Now, here's what happened with Logan Speed. Maybe this will give us a perspective of what happened here. He just kept turning left.
Yeah, he was trying to make a slide drop and he just couldn't get it in the process. And ended up collecting Caleb. A major setback for that 15 team.
Indeed it is. I see a slow motion replay off of the corner. But yeah, from that angle, it really looks like Logan Speed did it on purpose, but they had been touching bumpers throughout the entire corner, so it's tough to tell.
Yeah, they were possibly getting angry at each other and ended up boiling over into a big crash in turns 3 and 4 that ended up taking out Caleb Marinelli and Kyler Scott in the process.
Yep. Seth made some contact too, really jumbled up those last few cars.
What a shame.
As now we'll return to our live coverage with our pace car lights just going off. Our top 5, Dylan Jones, Caden Bishop out of nowhere into second. Zach Stern in third, Baron Poole fourth, and Tyler King in fifth.
Man, this is a very, very interesting top 5. And you know Zach Stern is going to make a run at this race lead again because he knows that two of the best cars at the moment are in the back or out of the race. He's just got to get around Cam Bishop and Dylan Jones at the moment.
And here they come to the green flag. Dylan Jones leads them to it with about 35 laps to go.
What a great start by that 20 car. He's got a huge gap on Cam Bishop at the moment. Can the competition behind him catch that 20 car?
And two cars on pit road with issues. It's General Jake and Jared Holmes.
What is that all about? I know there's no pit stops in this league.
Yeah, there must be some issues under the hood with those cars, but Dylan Jones has gotten off to a lead.
He's starting to pull away at the moment, but Cam Bishop is slowly climbing his way back to near Dylan Jones.
And they're battling behind him. Zach Stern almost made some contact with Baron Poole. Baron didn't quite have the speed there.
Oh, man. Baron Poole has been very quiet so far tonight, and he's finally making his way through the field once again and trying to get right by Zach Stern.
Now Jared's going to merge back onto the traffic.
Oh, no. Don't do that, Jared.
Right in front. He's going to hold up his teammate.
What a team owner. He just purposely possibly knocked his own car out of the top 10. Tanner Campus is a major risk of falling out.
Yeah, again, Tanner Campus in the battle for the points, too. That could be huge. But now Caden Bishop has lost two spots. Baron Poole the second. And now Zach Sherman is going to try to take that away. He just shoves him right out of the way. That was some big contact. Zach had enough with Baron at that point.
Zach is really, really frustrated behind the wheel of that race car. He wants to get that win. He feels like he should have won multiple times in recent weeks, and it's finally vented him to leash out some punishment on the competition.
Now they're gonna go side by side right behind him. Caden Bishop into the third position over Baron Poole.
Caden has slowly been up and down ever since this race restarted, but he's finally picking up the momentum. He has a very good long car at the moment. He could possibly make a run at the race lead if he can get by those two in front of him.
And there's also Tyler King in the fifth position trying to get around Baron. But our top three, same as what we restarted with Dylan Jones, Caden Bishop, and Zach Stern.
Gap is slowly closing in back on Dylan Jones. Zach Stern possibly could make a run at him, but he just needs to time the lines perfectly like Dylan Jones is.
Let's see what happens as this race progresses. We're almost at the halfway point with Caden Bishop trying to make a move on Zach Stern for the second position.
He's trying his best, and he might get him in the center of turns one and two. If he can get there, any possible will.
Side by side through turns 3 and 4, now on the backstretch into turns 3 and 4, and Caden just clears him.
Man, that one car has some major speed on the long runs, and he's possibly going to get him.
He's right down to the bottom, a little bit of contact being made down the back straightaway, and now it's Caden Bishop to the lead of the main event.
Man, oh man, another tight battle is heating up in the main event. Here comes Zach Stern on the bottom, trying to take the top spot away.
Zach Stern back to the lead, but now we're going to have some slow cars get in the way. That's Xander Thompson and J.D. Bregler.
Oh, man, this is going to be a big factor. Which line are
they going to block? Dylan, big contact. Oh, more contact. That was very close.
Oh, man, what a near incident between Zach Stern and Xander Thompson. But Zach Stern
And then there's going to be even more battling for second between Caden Bishop and Dylan Jones. This is exactly what Zach Stern wants to see.
He's got a quick breather at the moment because he knows Caden Bishop has a great car behind him, and Dylan Jones has been very close to Zach Stern throughout the entirety of this race. He's got to still worry about those guys behind him.
Now here they go through turns 3 and 4. It's going to be 20 laps to go at the stripe here. Zach Stern will lead with Caden Bishop second, Dylan Jones third.
Man, this battle is heating up, but there's possibly more lap cars in front of them. By the looks of it, I see Logan Speed and Brandon or Sydney Allen.
That is Sydney Allen in the 70 car. And then there's Caden Bishop kicking down low for the lead. There's making contact.
Oh, man, what a save by that one car.
There's a lot of dirt up there by the exit of turn two. There must have been a small incident between two drivers. No caution.
We're all good at the moment. Sexton made clear, along with Cam Bishop, what Dylan Jones, what can Dylan Jones do? He's going to get cleared by that too.
Zach just pulled a dangerous slide drop on Sydney Allen, and now it's Caden Bishop looking back to the inside for the lead.
Oh man, that one car has something for that eight, and he's possibly going to get him in turns one and two. Once again, no contact!
More contact being made, they're drifting up the track. Caden Bishop to the lead, and that contact's going to cause Zach to earn another position.
Man, that is a big whirlwind for Zach at the moment, but he has the speed to get back up there at any moment. He just needs to have some patience and climb his way back to the top spot.
But the top three remains the same despite all this battling. Tyler King and Tanner Campos have not been able to catch these three.
Lap traffic has really affected those two very badly. And here comes Seth Peters.
You talked about lap traffic. They're going to hold up the leaders as well. Zach Stern looking down to the bottom.
It's going to affect Dylan Jones and Caden Bishop. And here comes Zach Stern for the race lead.
Contact with the lap car. Zach Stern back to lead of this race. They're going to go three wide.
Oh my lord, this battle is heating up. Any one of these guys could possibly win it. Here comes Dylan Jones on the bottom.
Dylan Jones looking for the lead on Caden Bishop. More contact is made.
Oh man, Dylan shoves Caden Bishop up the track a little bit, but they made it all clear.
An aggressive move by Dylan Jones pays off with a double overtake to the lead here at Bristol.
Dylan Jones, who led the field back to the restart, is taking this top spot back, but he knows Caden Bishop and Zach Stern has something for him.
Here they come out of turn number four with a little under 10 laps to go. Here's Caden Bishop into the second position. Zach Stern trying to make a pass.
Man, the intensity is truly picking up. Here, I don't know what they're going to do at the moment. Caden Bishop's probably saving his equipment for the final few laps, but he's got to keep Zach Stern behind him.
10 laps to go here, and around goes Zach! Into the wall!
Oh no!
Right between the lap cars, but a caution is going to come out.
Oh no! The patience ran out on the A car, and it ended up knocking him out of contention for possibly the race win.
Oh, that is another heartbreak here for Zach Stern at Bristol.
Damn, I feel sorry for that A team. Zach Stern has put a lot of pressure on himself to get back to victory lane, and yet all that pressure finally built up and ended up taking him out of contention once again.
It's not fun at all. And Zach Stern, he keeps it inside the top 10. Luckily, Seth Peters and Colin Dover were able to avoid any extra contact, but here's a replay. Third in too deep.
Yeah, he was just throwing a Hail Mary right there. It ended up paying the price right there. But luckily, no one hit him. And he'll continue running the race. What is left of those race cars?
Here's an onboard with Zach. Just, again, threw it in too deep. Bit off more than he can chew. Now here's an onboard with Caden Bishop as they go into turn number one.
Zach is still on the gas, trying to make a pass for second place. And just like that, Caden Bishop will still have a chance to win this race, but Zach Stern will not.
Up a slow-mo cam here, right under that outside wall.
These drivers have been attempting slide jobs all night long, and it hasn't even worked for any of them. It's either led to a crash or taking them out of the race entirely. And this time, it's going to leave Zach with a broken heart.
But now, the lights on the pace car have gone off. We're going to have a four-lap shootout to decide this race.
The top two have remained the same throughout the entirety of this race, but we have some new contenders emerging, with Tanner Campos and Tyler King and Carter Jones, who has literally climbed his way from every heat and the main event to get a chance to win this race.
We'll see what happens. Pace car is about to make that hard left turn onto the pit lane. There he goes. As now Dylan Jones is going to take the green flag here. Four laps to go at Bristol.
Oh man, he didn't get a good restart that time. Caden Bishop stayed right close to him, and he's going to try to make a pass on him.
There's contact off turn number two. Dylan Jones keeps the lead.
Oh, man. Oh, this is getting very intense. But here comes Tyler King for third at the moment. But the battle still remains between Bishop and Jones.
Tyler King looking for his first Miss League win there in third. Caden Bishop and Dylan Jones battling hard for the lead. We're going to come to 2 laps to go.
Caden has to time this move right. He cannot do it now. He knows he can run down Dylan Jones at any moment. He's going to use it right here.
There they go down the back straightaway, side by side. Caden Bishop to the lead. Tyler King right there in third, about to take second. White flag.
Caden Bishop has to hold the world off behind him, but Tyler King has some momentum behind him. But I don't know if he can get there in time.
Through turns three and four, Tyler King might not have enough speed. There he is in the bottom, but it won't be enough. Caden Bishop wins at Bristol.
Wow, that was insane. Caden Bishop worked his ass off here tonight here at the Bristol Dirt Track, and he'll be celebrating in victory lane. Big props for him and that one team.
Amazing finish here for Caden Bishop, picking up CBMI's first victory in the Amsoil Dirt Late Model Series.
Life has truly changed for that one team and Caden Bishop himself, and here he comes to do a smoke show here in the Bristol Motor Speedway.
Yeah, Caden Bishop celebrating here during burnouts at the track that has always plagued his favorite NASCAR Cup Series driver.
Yep. And he's doing one hell of a burnout at the moment.
He's really spinning it sideways, hitting the wall. Burning out, second Miss League win here for the man in the one car.
He delivered the competition another present here on Christmas, the day after Christmas. And he's going to be celebrating victory lane at what is considered his home track.
As now he's going to continue to burn it out. It's a pretty long burnout here. He's going to keep throwing it sideways into the wall. And there it goes. Caden Bishop, winner here at Bristol. Special thanks to Connor Campos for joining me in the booth. Tune in next time on the NASCAR Fireball 48 channel when the Dirt Series goes racing at the Nürburgring. Thank